and safe at your home. Today, I am going to discuss with how to manage your references while you are writing your manuscript or dissertation work. So, first of all, let's understand why we give references, why we give the citations to the papers or to the scientific documents. We use the references so that we can prove that substantial research has been done to support our analysis, enable others to follow upon our work, and of course, we can give the credit to other people who have already worked on it. And obviously, as per the scientific ethics, we can avoid the charges of plagiarism. And last one, used to indicate the origin of material and source for research and further readings. So while we are going to move ahead for the referencing, few points which is very crucial to give the references are the author name, article title, journal name, year in which that particular paper was published, volume of the journal in which paper was published, and obviously the page number. To better understand about this, I am opening a sample paper. Here you can easily locate the name of the author who have published this work, name of the journal, which in this case this is Plant Gene, volume is 15, published in 2018, and page number is 44 to 50. Okay, so I think it is clear all the credentials that you should know. Now, once you know all these things, how to locate in a particular paper, there is the different styles of writing references. These references are not universal. Every journals have their own style. Some refer Harvard style of referencing, some say write in APA, some say do Vancouver, MLSS citation style, Chicago Manual of Style, and Royal Society of Chemistry style. So, which referencing style you have to follow? Before you start writing your manuscript, you have to go on the concerned journal's website. There you follow the instruction for the author. There you will come to know actually for that particular journal which referencing style you have to follow. Okay. So for sake of just example, here I am going to explain you what is the American Psychological Association style. So more or less all are same, but few differences are there that we are going to see later on. So first of all, I'm going to discuss American Psychological Association style. So in American Psychological Association style, what should be there? You should write down the author name followed by its initial, year of publication in bracket. So let's, as here the instructions are there, let me write down the referencing. Okay, so it's showing that author's name. So author's name, what I do, I just copy the author's name. Okay, so I will write down the references of this paper like this one, Vishwakarma Nutan Prakash something. So here what you have to do, you have to write down Vishwakarma first name N dot P. You don't have to write the full name, comma, Vasant Ba J J. Okay, fine. Vasant Ba J Jadeja. Full stop. Now, year of publication, that should be in bracket. So here my paper was published in, see, what was the year? Yeah, it's 2018. So here I write down 2018. Dot. Now, article title followed by full stop means article title I have to copy paste in the style. Okay, done. So I copy pasted full stop, name of journal in italic form. Good. So let me copy paste the name of the journal, Plant Gene, and that should be in italics as per the guideline of the APA. Sorry. Plant gene. Next, italic form, volume followed by a comma. So I am hitting comma, and volume number I can locate from my paper. It's a 15. Okay, so it's a 15. Then what? By a comma and page number. Then again I hit comma, page number. If I locate 44 to 50 in this case, so I write down 44 to 50, full stop. Then DOI means a digital object identifier, that you have to somehow in a paper you have to search it down. Yeah, this is the DOI. Okay, so I have copy pasted it from here. Okay, now this is the complete references, reference citation as per the APA style. If I open a paper like this one, here you can see exactly in the referencing style that I have started from giving the references from the page number. I think, let me scroll it down, long list of references, and you can see it here. It starts with the A and ends with the Y. So alphabetically the referencing style is arranged. So here, you if you count that how many papers I have given as a citation, so we will found not less than, I guess, not less than 40 to 50 papers, or more than that it may be. So just imagine, once you are writing your dissertation and you are giving the citation in such a way as I did in manually, obviously it is going to take a lot of time, and your lot of time is going to be wasted. Okay, so today the motive of the work which I have done manually, so that you can understand the difficulty and how softwares can help you out to solve your referencing problem and to save your time. Let me tell you very clearly one thing I always quote, that none of the, obviously the software, using software is good, you can work smartly, but none of the single software is in the world which is better than the human brain. So what I suggest you, once you use any software, you just take the support of software. You don't be handicapped that whatever software is giving the output, that is 100% true. Obviously, whatever software is going to do, you have to manually rectify it. You just can take the support of the software. Okay, I will explain it again why I am saying it. Okay, so there is a lot of softwares are there which can manage your references. You don't have to do it manually. One of the very good software which is freely open source is Mendeley. Mendeley is a very good reference manager with which you can manage your references. So how you can use the Mendeley, I am telling you step by step. First of all, you have to just click on the download. Once you will click on the download, a fresh page will open. Simply, now it depends that which operating system you are using, whether you are working with the Windows, are you working with the Linux, are you working with the Mac. So here I am using the Windows. So what I do, I just click on downloading Mendeley desktop for Windows. Once you click on it, a setup file will be downloaded. I have already downloaded, so that's why I'm not downloading it. Once the setup file you have, you just click on next, 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 your software will be installed in your computer. All right. So once you have installed in your computer, the screen will be like this one. Let me tell you, let me show you, just like the Mendeley desktop have been installed in my PC. So once I click on it, obviously it depends on the computer processor, it may take your time. It asks the email and password. Without entering email and password, you will not be able to use Mendeley. Okay, So how to get, which user ID and password you have to enter before, normally say you have what students are generally doing, they have the Gmail ID and they enter the Gmail ID and their password of Gmail. Obviously it is not going to help you. You need the separate password for the Mendeley. So what you can do, you just go on the Mendeley, click on the sign in, or else you can create the create account. First time, one time you have to create your account. Just like say for example you are using the Facebook, all right? So until you don't create your user ID and password with the Facebook directly, you can't post anything on the Facebook. So likewise, here I have already registered, that's why it always already showing the my mail ID. You don't have to do that. First time you have to click on the sign in with a different account, and whatever questions it is going to ask you, like email, then whatever password you want to keep, your personal details and all. Once you give all the details, your user ID and password will be created. User ID is usually your Gmail ID or any other email ID will work, and password, customized password you set for the Mendeley. So well, I accept that I think you have created the user ID and password. Now you, once you have the user ID and password, here I am entering my user ID and password to log in on the Mendeley. Okay, so let me type it. So it is pranutan@gmail.com, and here I am putting my password, which I have set personally for my use. Okay. So let it sign in. Done. So now, as you can see, your Mendeley have been opened. You did not found anything on the page. It's just like Mendeley desktop. Here my name comes, and here a lot of options are there. You can do a lot of things, like first time you can create your folder. Suppose say for example, here I can I'm going to write a paper, so I can put any name, like I can write on the paper. Okay, so whatever here, so one folder have been created named as paper. Okay, paper. Okay, so here a lot of facilities are available. You can add, so let me click on the add file, or you can, if any already folder you have in which you have put your all the papers which you are going to cite in your manuscript, so that create a folder, or you can just, if I click on this one, see directly folder have been created, new folder. Let me delete it out because I don't remember this at this moment. I don't need this. So if I click on the paper, I go on the add files. Some, for example, I have many papers which I have kept on the desktop, and these are the papers which I'm going to cite in my work. So I'm just opening it in my Mendeley. Okay, so it will take some time, depends how many paper you are calling it at a time. Suppose 5 to 6 papers I have called it here, so it takes, depends how many papers you are scrolling it at a time. So you can see clearly, you can see the best benefit of this Mendeley desktop is you can sort it by the name of the title. If I click on the title, you can click, you can check it out here that all the paper titles have been arranged, sorted as per the A to Z. Okay, alphabetically the paper, as per the paper title it is arranged. If you want to arrange it, sort it by just the name of the year, in a year, so you can check it out here. The all papers have been arranged as per the chronological order, like 2010 to 2018. If you want to sort it down as per the name of the journal, again you can do it. Okay, so these are some functions. Let me do it, sorting by the name of the journal. Here you can see the name of the authors, and here some buttons are there, like it is showing green. Okay, so I can make it. Okay, here suppose I'm opening one paper, suppose my paper is this one. I'm opening this paper. The beautiful part of this Mendeley is I in a single window I can open all the papers, 10, 50, how as much paper you want you can open in a single window. Okay, so and easily you can switch over. Done. And the best part is, suppose I'm reading this chapter, I'm reading this paragraph, and I want to write down something here, what I can do here, very simple. Here something is there like notes and all. So what I can do here I can put note. See, if I put it note, whatever I want to write, I can write down and I can save it out. Just like I click somewhere, you can clearly see that note is here. Okay. And whenever you want to reopen it, what I have written, I have just can do. And if I want to highlight anything which is important for me, see, this property is not available with the PDF. Okay. So I have just selected it out. So I can highlight it. Okay. You can clearly see it is highlighted now. And if I close it, it will be with as such it will be. Okay. So these are the some points. And suppose once I gone through all the literatures, I found that say you have 10 to hundreds of papers, and you think that you have read this paper and read this paper. So whatever papers you have already referred, that you can put it in the green signal, so that once you again open the Mendeley, you will come to know how many papers you have referred. Okay, so it is good one. And suppose I found this particular paper is very informative and very good, so I can mark it star as well. So now these are the basic functions of Mendeley. Now let us see how Mendeley can help us to give the citation. Okay, sorry. So just sorry for the bit disturbance. So now let us understand how Mendeley can help us to write down the citation. So for example, how we can open, suppose here I am creating one Word file. Okay, see, this is the Word file. Yeah, and one more thing, before you open the Word file, one thing I forgot to tell you, that before you do first time, before you open the Word file in which you are preparing your manuscript, you do one thing, go on the Mendeley, click on the tools, and first time once you open the tools, here will be option will be the install MS Word plugin. I have already installed it, that's why means option comes as uninstall. So say for example, first time I am uninstalling it for sake of example. Now what you have to do first time, you will see the option just like this one, install MS Word plugin. Here the main thing you have to understand, that once you are doing this step, until you are not doing this step, you will not be able to use Mendeley. Okay. And one thing you have to make sure, once you are hitting on this install MS Word plugin, make sure any Word file is not opened in your computer. Okay. So here, that's why I closed the MS Word. So now MS Word is closed. Now click on install MS Word plugin. This is the single step process. Now you don't have to do it again. Okay. So now I am opening the new Microsoft Word document. Okay, fine. It will take some time. Fine. So suppose this is the thesis, dissertation, whatever like paper I am writing. So suppose I am just reading this particular paper. I'm taking this example. Suppose I am reading this paper, and by reading this particular paper, I am writing something in my manuscript. So for sake of, you know, for example, I am just randomly writing ABCD, and here that in relative you have to write down something. Okay, now suppose this much line I have written by reading this particular paper. So how I can give the citation to this paper? For that, simply what I have to do, just simply copy the title of the paper. Okay, let it select it here, otherwise it will be highlighted. So okay. So copy here. Now in the Word file, what you have to do, you have to go on the just references. Here one icon you will see, that is insert citation. Once you click on the insert citation, what I did in that install MS Word plugin, there we make the connection between the Mendeley and Word. Okay, so once you do this, you will find this particular icon in your Word, insert citation. If you click on this, one window will be open which is of Mendeley. Here you can paste whatever title you have pasted. You will find that identification and characterization, wherever identification and characterization is written. Now you have to manually identify that three papers are showing. So obviously if I see that the name of the paper which was reading gone through, that the identification characterization of miRNA. So it's wrongly taken the citation. Manual edit. Okay, so insert citation, let me again search it out. Insert citation. Okay, so identification and characterization of miRNA transcriptome in Jatropha occurs. Once I click, now I just press on OK. Once I have press on OK, it is already given the citation that Prakash and Jadeja 2018. Now only one time you have to do one more work, that click on the insert bibliography. Once I hit the insert bibliography, you can clearly see here is the Prakash and Jadeja 2018 and the details are as under downside. Suppose I have written it, and again I have written some lines, and I want to cite one more paper which is in my library of the Mendeley. So suppose next paper I am going to cite, that is this one I am taking, yeah, prediction of miRNA, right? So prediction of miRNA in HIV-1. Now what I am doing, the same thing, click on insert citation, paste. You can clearly see that whatever paper was in my Mendeley library, that is appearing here. So I just click on it, click on OK. Now just see the beauty of the Mendeley. Here two citations are there, like Prakash and Jadeja 2018, Gupta, Agrawal, Prakash, Singh, Mishra 2012, and you see that Prakash was the first, and now Gupta the second one which I have cited, that automatically arranged, you know, as per the alphabetical order. If I again write some lines based on reading or my analysis and I want to cite some more papers, then definitely you can clearly, you know, suppose I want to cite this paper, identification of miRNA. So again what I can do, I just go on the insert citation, click on it, click on OK, and rest software will do. So you can see that all the work which you have to previously do by manually, there is a very tired and very time taking process. Now all the worries you can leave on the Mendeley. Everything will be automatically done. The only thing you have to take care, as per the guideline of your university or any journal, you have to manually verify it. You don't have to believe it that whatever software have done that is correct. Okay, you don't have to do it. At least let me try to some try to find some loophole what software have done. Okay, so here you can see, as per I previously explained, that as per the APA style, there should be the name of the, let me zoom it, the name of the journal should be in italics. Obviously it is here. Name of the volume. Okay, and after volume it wrongly put it for, which is known as maybe issue. But if I open the same file, the name of the file is prediction of miRNA something. Okay, yeah. Now if I locate this particular, if I open this particular paper, let me find out where is the volume. So volume, since it is online published paper by Springer, see the volume is not here. I'm not finding any kind of the volume here throughout the paper. Okay, so if no volume is there, then obviously it is the volume number one. So it is done smartly by the Mendeley. And obviously if volume is not there, then issue will not be there. So 4 is entered wrongly by Mendeley. So you have to delete it. 141 to 151. The page number, obviously the page number, let me find out whether the software have done it correctly or not. So you can clearly, you can see, since it's the online paper, so obviously the page number is not here in this case. Okay, so if page number is not there, no problem, it's okay. If page number is not there, I don't know from where it have taken. That's why I was telling you that whenever you use the software, you don't have to believe that whatever the software have done, that is correct or not. Once at least to verify. So definitely it is going to save your time, but it doesn't mean that whatever software have done, that is correct. Okay, so you have to verify it. Otherwise it will create some difficulty while you are publishing the paper. Okay, one more very important thing which I would like to mention here. Say for example, you have prepared your manuscript in here you can see it is the American Psychological Association. Okay, or suppose you are, unfortunately your paper have been rejected and you are approaching to another journal, and journal says that we follow the different guideline. So you just imagine, if you have prepared your manuscript, means citation, manually, and your paper have been rejected, and now the another journal says, okay, we accept the in nature style or Vancouver style, then definitely you have to rearrange everything from starting to the end. That is again time taking process. It is going to take a lot of time and a lot of effort. Here Mendeley is going to help you very smartly. What you have to do, suppose this manuscript is, you have you have submitted to any journal and they have rejected it, no problem. Now you are approaching to another journal. Very smartly, what you can, in a single click, American Psychological Association will be converted in any other citation style. See, it's magical. So what I do, I just click on Nature. Suppose in Nature you want to publish, okay? So just click on Nature. See what happened? Rather than author and date, it is automatically converted into 1, 2, 3, and it is arranged as per the number. Again, your paper got rejected. Now suppose you want to publish it in another, like Vancouver. See, just single click I have to do, and your paper is ready to submit in another journal, Vancouver. See what happened? Now your referencing is as per the number 1, 2, 3. Previously in the Nature, the one was in the superscript form. Here it is in normal text, 1, 2, 3. So I think now you will be able to do your citation, your referencing very easily, and you can save your time and you can focus yourself only on the research. You don't have to waste your time while referencing the citations. And obviously, I am very sure it is going to help you. Thank you all. If you like this particular video, if you have any query, you can leave a comment. And thanks for watching. Do subscribe, share, and like the videos. Thank you all.